Kiskeam it is, a lovely place, with lots of lovely people, and lovely flowers outside their door, and should that's the way to keep it. Thank you.
Kiskeam, a very, very nice part of the country. We have scenery, we have beautiful, tidy, clean village, thanks to our post office men, John Petty, Joe Murphy. We have entertainment, we have music, we have a famous fiddler, Maurice O'Keefe, and we are very, very lucky to have such nice people in the community.
John Murphy Post, I was Kiskeam, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm here since 1960.
Are you?
1960, that's right, yeah.
And do you remember what it was like then?
Pardon?
Do you remember what it was like in 19...
It was a different island,
yeah.
Completely different. People were... You know, but a lot of the old things have gone now. The creamery is gone. A lot of the shops have gone. And I would think that when I'm finished, that it'll be the last post office here.
You have
possibly
a what?
That, you know, that kind of cut them out completely, and people do their business with the banking, two machines and all that thing.
You've a while to go yet, though, have you?
Mm-hmm.
You'll be open a while yet.
Well, that's to myself, I could have retired years ago.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I hear you've been fighting for the post office to keep it open, is that
yeah,
right?
That's right, yeah. That's right, yeah. Yeah.
This is your pint here, so do you want to tell me who you are?
I'm Jen Kelly.
The one with you.
Kiskeam.
Yeah. And have you lived here all your life?
Nothing enough, but I'm back in the terrace.
Yeah. And you're well retired now, are you? Yeah.
I'm retired for the years.
Yeah. Do you want to tell me about the bar here and the people in it?
The best bar that I would give, the best people you ever see.
And why would you say that there now? Let me just sweep around here.
Lovely people, good weather.
Yeah. And what did you used to work at before you retired?
Make energy.
Yeah.
Another bandit.
No, that's quite too nice. I get to wish you for energy.
Good weather for the farmers this summer. With having saved in June, and people are happy around here. We're coming from a few of them.
And you work in agriculture,
yeah? Yeah, I work in Anya.
Yeah.
I'm a small farmer, but not a big one. Happy farming, though. Prices are better than me and from cattle. We're happy.
Very good.
I went to school in Kiskeam. I went to primary school in the school over there. I'm the publican's daughter. Lovely pub. We did it up there last August. It was especially done just for my 21st. Well, before my 21st. It took 2.5 weeks to be done.
Tell them about the play.
Music, we have music here.
You've jumped up to play.
We have music here every Sunday night. And we've Keely nearly once a month at least. Yeah, it's a great pub and a great atmosphere. You should come on.
This is Maurice O'Keefe. He's our famous fiddler of the traditional Irish music. And he will give you a few words. He will speak to you on Kiskeam.
No. At that time, we'd say the Araglin behind there was just about maybe 6 feet wide, 2 yards wide. And the hag, she was running from her pursuer who was after her. And of course, she had a long step from behind the Kiskeam bridge, behind there, the bridge there. And the other side, there's a rock on each side. Was that time, she took a step, what's called Coisceim. Kiskeam is a step. Yeah. And she baffled him, and she was never caught. She was called Coisceim. Yeah. Coisceim. That's how it got its name. The step of the old hag. In other words, I think it means, yeah.
We've our TD and councillors, and they're doing everything to promote the village and long life.
John Paul O'Shea, is it?
No.
No.
Bernard Meinen and Michael Meinen, the TD.
You're related to this?
Son of Maurice O'Keefe.
Yeah. And
very involved in GA.
Are you?
And I'm going very bad at the moment, but hopefully things will pick up in the coming year.
I heard that.
And our underage are going very well. But other than that, then hopefully things will go better next year.
Dennis Flaherty.
And you're from here?
Yeah, I live in here. I'm originally from the market.
Yeah. And how do you like it here?
All right, they can't get rid of me now.
Have you committed a crime?
I got thanks be to God, no.
And are you a family man?
Pardon?
A family man yourself?
I am, yes.
And are you working in Kiskeam?
No, I'm working in Belly Desmond, in Munster Janery.
Yeah, everybody seems to work in Munster Joint.
Yeah, only for that place would be all right.
It's a good old feeling. Camaraderie around the place, and people here would die for an harmony anyway.
And you were telling me about what it was like a long time ago.
Well, we were here 36 years, and it was, you know, there was no footpaths,
there
was no infrastructure really. Yeah. And then,
no sewage, no water.
We had sewage.
Yeah? We had bits of it.
Bits of it, just great, yeah. And then the water scheme came. And then we had a village renewal. In what year had we a village renewal?
1994, I suppose. We stopped in 1994. Our post office was put under threat in 1994. We stopped at a campaign to try and save the post office. And then all the community got together. And we decided we'd start a campaign to update our village. And Noel Dillon was the county manager at the time. and under the British renewal scheme, Noel Lennon came in and he poured money into Kiskeam. Got our footpaths, got our water up to date, got our storage and everything. He did everything in his power for us.
Who is he?
Noel Dillon, he was the county manager, the Cork county manager.
And get
of course we had Father Griffin at the time, he was our curate. He was a good priest and he got involved in everything. He goaded people into working and like
doing it in your hand.
Yeah. In 1994 then our shop got burned to the ground here. And Griffin led the campaign there. He got all the community working. They had us back in business within a week. And there, I was involved in this post office campaign. We kind of went national with the post office campaign at the time. We got a lot of publicity out of it. As a result of that, the village got a lot of publicity. We entered the Tidy Towns competition. Someone had entered us the year before. We were adjudicated the duckiest village in Ireland. So we entered this and we got the best new entry award. And we've been increasing our marks every year since then. Okay.
My name is Anne.
And you live here a long time.
I'm living over across the river here, over across in a place called Nakabori. I went to school in the school there in Kiskeam from about 1960 to 1963.
Come on.
Isn't he the greatest schoolboy?
Do you want to talk to him and ask him how he is?
He's not verbal, so you can't.
Yeah.
Who's your banker? Yeah. What do you think of him? What about Kerry?
Oh.
Up, cock. Hey, babe.
You want to tell me about the...
That building with the paintings over there, that is the old creamery here. And we got a painter from Rock Chapel by the name of Paddy Ronan in to do the paintings. And a short time after he doing paintings, I think to the brain tumor he got, but he died anyway. So he'll always be remembered in Kiskeam.
And what's the name of this place where you're working?
There is.
Yeah. And do you like it here?
Well, it's fine. Yeah. Okay. It's all right.
And you're here a long time now?
8 years.
8 years?
Yeah.
So you're settled into Kiskeam now? You're settled down?
I'm from Ballydesmond.
Oh, you're from Ballydesmond, yeah. And how do you find Ireland? Do you like Ireland?
That's okay.
Yeah.
It's okay. It's okay, this weather is different, it's okay.
Been in Kiskeam all my life.
And you're waiting to do something here, are you?
Yeah, we're delivering turf now.
Okay.
I'm George Fisher, I'm living in Kiskeam as well. I'm delivering turf as well, but I'm working Munster Joiner and starting back Tuesday.
Okay.
Full-time job.
You're not from Kiskeam, are you?
No, I'm not from Kiskeam, I'm not native abroad. My name's Brian Healy, and I'm going to be talking today as well. I'm from Elms and Mill Street, and fortunately I've got extra work today.
You're from Mill Street, are you?
Yeah.
Tell me about the footprints.
I can only tell you a little bit, because I haven't seen them myself. And they're 100 years old this year, and they're supposed to disappear. The curse is supposed to occur this year, mate, and they're going to be gone.
How did they come about?
A fellow was shot there. Oh, Christ. during the war.
Kiskeam it is, a lovely place, with lots of lovely people, and lovely flowers outside their door, and should best way to keep it. Thank you.